of why people do what they do. Now, finally, there's this thing called a contract, which we use in just about every behavior modification program. Whether you're dealing with children, adolescents, or adults, a contract is a very useful thing to know how to use. Here's an example of a contract. It's an anger-specific contract, but you can change it. For substance use, you also sign contracts. You know why? Contracts create commitment. You tell the client, you know what, this is not legally binding. We all know that. I'm not an attorney. I'm a psychologist. This is not legally binding, but what we have found over the years, and others too, is that when patients sign a contract to stop drugging and drinking, let's say, when they sign a contract to refrain from, you know, any kind of maladaptive behavior, they actually become committed to it, even though it's not legally binding. And, sorry, I meant to show you an example of a contract. So here's our contract against anger. We tell them, all right, the desired behavior is to avoid getting angry, to avoid taking offense at what others say and do, at least unnecessarily taking, to refrain from retaliation or passive aggressiveness against others. And for every day without anger, you get 1 point. For every anger event, you lose a point, right? So negative consequences too. And then for a full week without anger, you get a bonus, 3 points. And then people, you know, it's amazing. People get a real sense of reward just from points. And then they come back to you and they say, okay, what can I do with these points? And you say, well, what would you like to do? What would do you think would be a reasonable reward? Oh, I'd like to go and watch a movie. Or I'd like to go to a favorite restaurant of mine. And so this becomes motivating and reinforcing. As I said, someday when you try to help people, you'll find that they will be very invested if they have already signed a contract. All right.